Okay, so we look really busted right now, and that is because I just got home from work. Literally less than 30 minutes ago, I came in, had my peanut butter and jelly, and now I'm here. Okay, so I'm sweaty, I feel gross, I feel like I look gross, you know. We're not in our best state of mind, but I'm hoping Sabrina's album can pick me up, okay? I'm ready to listen to album of the year right here, okay? So we're gonna be like listening to it live. I'm going to be skipping the singles that are already released because I already have listened to them. So every other song I will be reacting to, okay? So we're really going in a deep dive here. Disclaimer, I'm not a music critic. I'm not. I might have the worst music taste ever, but I don't care. Okay, so I'm not listening, y'all. I have too many copyrighted videos. I am not going to be playing her album for you. You're gonna be listening to, I don't know. I really don't know what you're gonna be listening to, but it's not gonna be Sabrina. So, hey, if you wanna actually listen to her, go to her album. This is just my reaction, okay? There we go. So I have it pre-saved on Spotify. Where is it? Maybe I don't because I can't find it. Where is it? First song is Taste. This is an interesting direction. These lyrics, this is a good first song. It kind of like hypes you up. Okay, the song is good. The song, I've reached my conclusion. This is a first listen. I think it's really good as a first song because it kind of like hypes you up. Is it my favorite Sabrina song at the moment? No, but I think it serves its purpose. It kind of like details what was going on back when she was with like Sean and Camila. I don't know. I heard that's what the song's about, so that's what I'm rolling with. Right now, I'm gonna give it like 6 out of 6. Keep in mind, this is harsh. This is a harsh grading for me. For me personally, right now it's a 6. That's good, by the way. That is good, okay? Okay, next song. Please, please, please. That's like a 10 out of 10. So next one, Good Graces. I did not expect this sound from her. Lots of guys, you do something suspect, this cute as bye-bye. Like, ooh, baby, you say you really like it being mine. So let me give you that complicated. Wow, the chorus. Not that complicated, you should say it. Wow. This sounds like an Ariana song, and in the best way. Oh my god, the lyrics are wild. She really said, I don't give an F about y'all. Mm-hmm. That one's definitely better than Taste. For sure. That's like an 8. That's like, again, all these songs I think will grow on me. So like, obviously, we need more listens. But like, I did not expect that sound from her at all. The next song is Sharpest Tool. We had sex, I met your best friends. Then a bird flies by and you forget. Till your guilt creeps in on a Tuesday. We never talk about it. Okay, the bridge leading up, or the chorus? I don't know music, y'all. On the headphones, it's like going back and forth. The vocals. Okay, opinion on Sharpest Tool. Cutesy. It's a cutesy song. Again, do I like it as much as Good Graces? No, but I do like it. And I think actually this one will grow on me more. But it's good. It's good. The harmonization is crazy. The vocals are crazy. It's good. It's good. It's good. What would I rank it? Maybe like 7, 6.5, maybe. Coincidence is the next song I'm listening to. Second, I put my head on your chest. She knew she's got a real sixth sense. And you lost the vocals. Okay, again, this one, did not expect her to do this sound on her album. It sounds country, I don't know if it is country. It's like acoustic country maybe, pop country, acoustic, I don't know. Listen, the chorus, the lead up to the chorus, I really don't know. I think it's the chorus is really good. I'm pretty sure it's the chorus. But like, this just sounds like a song that would play in the end credits of a rom-com where they're all dancing. That's the only way I can describe it. But it's like good vibes. It's fun vibes. It's fun. If I had to rank it, probably 7 out of 10. Okay, next is Bad Chem. Bed Chem. Bed Chem. She did it. She did it again. Lyrics, funny, giving nonsense energy. Wow, the lyrics are so like, she does a play on words a lot, which I like. Okay, so again, this does also sound like a song that Ariana would do. 8 out of 10. So far, I still like this single's better than all of the songs so far. I don't know if it's because I listen to them more, but I still like Espresso more and Please 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 more than all of these. And don't hate me. So far, I'm still liking Emails I Can't Send more, but I don't know. I don't know. It's tough. Let me see. Okay, we're barely through, so. But yeah, Bed Chem is good and like a very well-produced song. Like, you can just tell, like, that's a good one. Okay, next is Espresso. Again, like, that's like 10 out of 10. That's like great song of the summer. The next song after that is Dumb and Poetic. Oh, is this a sad one? Just 'cause you talk like one. You can just feel the emotion in this song. Like, she's like speaking to someone. Okay, thoughts on this one? This is like a sad song. It's okay, it's okay. You can feel the emotion in it, but I feel like I have to listen to it more. Like, I feel like this song will grow on me. But again, like, I feel like 6 out of 10. But yeah, you can totally, like, she is speaking directly to someone in this song. Next song, Slim Pickens. I really hope I like this one. I really hope I do. I liked them all so far, but I like the vibe of the name of this one, so I really hope, like, this one does it for me. Find his has to save my life, oh, it's kind of country, this one. A boy who's nice that breathes, I swear. Okay, this one's good. This one's good. This one, I would put 7. Totally country. It reminds me of kind of like old Casey, giving kind of like follow your arrow vibes in the musical sense, and like not the lyrics, but you know what I'm talking about. Interesting. I just find it interesting how much she genre skips on this album. She's doing like R&B, she's doing country, she's doing pop. We will see where the next song takes us, okay? Juno. Okay, I'm excited about this one too. Please, 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 please. I think I'm gonna like this one. This one's fun. I like the beat. This one I feel sounds the most similar to the singles, like Espresso. But I like this one. This one's gonna be popular. This one's gonna be really popular. This one's really catchy too. Okay, this one's really fun, very upbeat song. I just feel like it's like positive. It's like, it's not too, it doesn't take itself too seriously, this song. This song's a good song. This song is a good song. Honestly, I think I have a feeling this one could be a single. Like, this one sounds like it could be a single. I think she's promoting Taste as a single right now, but I have a feeling this one might be a single. It just gives me that vibe in a good way, in a good way. So far, but ignoring the singles that already came out, my favorites are Good Graces, Bad Chem, and Juno. Those are my favorites so far. I don't hate any of these songs. I don't. But I will have to listen to these songs more, 100%. Because I already forget what half the songs sound like, except those that stood out to me. But again, so far, I might put Emails I Can't Send above it. The deluxe version of Emails I Can't Send so far is beating this. But again, we still have two more songs left. So these songs, you know, if this album for me wants to beat Emails I Can't Send, these songs have to blow me away. Okay, this is Lie to Girls. Don't swear on your mom that it's the first. I recognize this like melody. Like a month. No, don't say it was just an isolated incident that happened once. This sounds like a sample. This one's good. All your best excuses. We're having a little beat change. This one's good. We love to mistake butterflies for cardiac arrest. We love to mistake butterflies for cardiac arrest. This one is also going in the favorites of this album. This one's really good. Really fresh, this one. This one's really fresh, I feel like. This whole album to me feels fresh in terms of sound. For me, I don't know, I might be delusional, but a lot of it, some of this, you know, I said the one song sounded like Casey Musgraves a little bit, but that might be just because it's country, but this one's really fresh, I feel like, this song, for me. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Next song, Don't Smile. I won't. Is this R&B? I could fall asleep to this song in the best way. It's like a lullaby. Definitely R&B, obviously. Okay, this one is just a good song. I don't know how else to describe it, but it's like good. Like it's a staple. It's like a good song. Like no more, no less, it's a solid song. So that's, you know, 7 out of 10. I mean, I guess I like coincidence too. Out of this album, This might be unpopular. So far, I like Emails I Can't Send Deluxe better. I don't know if that's gonna be an unpopular opinion. I don't know. Not saying this album is bad. It does have bops on it, and I know like these will be like replayed. Like obviously, like this is a good album. Again, like I said, like let me just name all the songs. I'll include the singles here. Like Please, Please, Please is really good. Good Graces is really good. Coincidence, Bed Chem, Espresso, Juno, Lie to Girls. Those are like my favorites. So that's like half the album, but it's definitely more mature than her last album, obviously. But I have to listen to it more. It's a solid album. I think these songs have to grow on me more because it is so different from her normal sound. Does that make sense? Like what you're used to hearing from her, this ain't like it. I would say a different sound for her, which is something to get like used to. Not saying it's bad, but it's just different, so I have to listen to it more. We love Sabrina, okay? But this is me being honest. I have to listen to it more. If I were Pitchfork, I would give it like a 7, this album, or like a 6.9. Like, it's a good album. I can't even compare it to Guts. They're not comparable, these two albums, not in the slightest comparable, because they're completely different. But I do have to listen to this one more. Again, it's really good. So if you weren't a fan of the last album, you might really like this one. And it totally might be opposite, where like you don't like this one, but I have to think on it. I have to think about my opinion. I have to let the songs not ruminate. I have to let them like, I have to hear the songs a million times is what I'm trying to say to really decide. But that is my reaction. I'm about to re-listen to it. So I'll keep you posted when I unbox the vinyls, how my opinions have changed.